Welcome back, Hordlings, to more Baldur's Gate 2. We're outside of Sindai's enclave, but we're actually going to go to Watcher's Keep at this point and get it over with.
Want me to do what, huh?
Trust is for the foolish.
And hurrah! Excuse me! I can do it!
This be a grand enough lot. Mayhap I won't be needing to kill you all anytime soon.
Yes! I am controlled by no one.
It's mine.
Now, we did some of Watcher's Keep already in the original Shadows of Arm, so I think the first level of it's done. Bag of holding, alright. Well, at least we can finally sell all this shit. What else here? Quarterstaff 2 we don't need.
Time to make Gib soup. Are we there? Boom shakalaka.
All right, let's get it on. And I think this is the only floor we cleared.
Lutlup may not be smart, but he really good looking and have big ding dong.
Thank you.
you have me do?
Next swing!
Yes, Abil?
I am. That is what I am.
Hurro!
Next swing!
I shall follow your strength.
Huh?
Etchings on the dais portray a man in priestly robes chanting on an altar that holds a book, a bell, and a candle.
No problem for Lug Lug. Holy slime! This better be worth Lug Lug's time!
I don't have the Zone of Sweet Air spell memorized, unfortunately.
Huh? Want me to do
I
what,
do
huh?
Very well.
Are we there yet? Hurro! Huh? Lug Lug ready to crush Skull!
Scream! Scream! Scream for mercy!
Are we ready when you are? Hurrah!
I need
this
plus
better
two
be
bullets
worth Lug's time, huh?
Considering we have infinite.
Want me to do what, huh?
History of the Imprisoned One. He also serves who stands and waits and watches carefully. Such is the lesson of the great guard helm of the unsleeping eyes. Let the events of this forgotten temple serve as an example to all who would follow the Vigilant One. Beneath this hollowed earth, the avatar of the Watcher confronted great evil, a prince of the underplanes. Through steadfast perseverance, Helm, guardian of the gods, fulfilled his sacred duty and bound the creature in the bowels of the temple that it might walk the world no more. Speak not the beast's name, ye knights of the vigil, but guard this place. Protect the wards which seal the imprisoned one within, and remain ever watchful. Never betray your trust. Such is the will of Helm.
Are we... Excuse me!
The artifact's now in place, the altar shimmers and glows as you approach. The very stones beneath your feet tremble with caged power. The ritual has begun.
Ring my bell!
The bell chimes once and the glow of the altar pulsates in response. The bell chimes a second time and the temple shudders as the magic gathers. A tiny blue flame of the candle burns with an unnatural intensity. You lay the book face up on the altar, but it slams itself shut. You realize you cannot continue the ritual until you somehow discover the proper page to which you must open the book. You replace the ritual items in your backpack and leave the altar for the time being. When you return, you have to perform the ritual from the beginning again. Ah, we need to learn what page to go to. Hmm. even been in here.
Whoa!
Subtly made and subtly maintained, but good killing grounds nevertheless.
An inscription on the sarcophagus. Here lies our faithful servant. Despite the somewhat suspect memory in his later years, he served with duty and honor. If you wanted to, you can move the heavy lid and peer inside. You push the heavy lid aside, but before you can inspect the contents, there's an angry roar. You sense you have business to take care of.
You should not have come to this place. For a thousand years, I've slept in peace, forgotten by the world beyond these temple walls. Now you dare disturb my eternal rest. Oh, I see you've brought my slippers. How thoughtful, may I have them?
Sure, take the slippers.
I apologize for my undeserved reaction. I will take my slippers and let you finish your work here. Look through the sarcophagus if you wish.
Okay.
Inside the sarcophagus lie the remain of the old priest's possessions. Woven into the sleeve of a ceremonial robe is the following holy ritual, chapter 7, verse 14. You make a mental note of it. Alright, now we know where to open the book to.
What would you have me do?
Hexit has gained a level. Works for me. More traps! Damn it, more traps. Superhuman effort, a high level rook can avoid almost certain death. Yeah. Set traps. Oh, and we're inside, so there you go.
Hurrah! I can do it!
Let's put my cheetah paws back on.
What do you? You will feel my wrath!
Lay the book on the altar, open to the chapter and verse that were woven into the sleeve of the old priest's cloak, and recite the passage. You ring the bell a third time. Behind you, the mirrored portal begins to glow. The gate to the lower levels is now open.
Huh? Boom shakalaka! Are we there? Luglug may not be smart, but he really good looking and have big ding dong. Hello!
Mind your toes.
Be quick with it! A skull breaker!
I'll rip you apart, you way-faced
fool!
Die quickly, fool!
I'll rip you apart, way-faced.
And a level 4 Vaconia! I guess you can only take those once. We'll go with Aura of Flaming Death. It sounds cool.
No problem for Hubba.
Dark fire plus four bow is better than the plus three Heartseeker. Ooh, some plus three arrows. We have the ingredients we need to have Cespinar upgrade our quiver to plus two plenty.
This better be worth Luglug's time!
The mirror homes with energy. The gate to the lower dungeon is now open.
More suicidal fanatics willing to die in the service of Helm, I see. Or have you been forced into service, as I once was a millennium ago?
I serve no one but myself, demon. I am here looking out for my own interest.
Sounds like you have been tricked into doing Helm's dirty work. Looks like we are both unwilling participants in this little drama.
Perhaps you should show me the way down to the next level, and I'll see if I can get us both out of this mess.
Listen, friend. We can help each other. The fact of the matter is, you cannot get through the gate to the next level unless I open it for you. So I'm not going to let you through the gate unless you help me end the enchantment that has kept me bound in this infernal dungeon for the last 1,000 years. Do we have a deal?
What must be done?
Glad you've decided to be reasonable. The Helmites were never reasonable. It is so much easier to deal with one who isn't a fanatic.
Oh, you're not going to read your last lines?
Lazy bastard. This cage I'm stuck in was fashioned over 1,000 years ago by four archmages who combined the power of four diverse elements to imprison me here for all eternity. How can I get you out? The wizards who trapped me here each had a lab on the level of the dungeon where they worked to fashion the enchantments of my cage. Each wizard created a scepter to focus the channel of his power. Only combined power of the four scepters can lock or unlock my cage. I will find the scepters. What next?
Gather the scepter keys and place them in the four slots around the cage. Once free, I'll be on my way. And you can go through the gate and take on the imprisoned one. If you still want to.
Did he say four slots? All right.
To do what, huh? Are we there yet? What now?
Fire giant.
Make up your mind. Get on with it. Hurrah! This better be worth Mugmug's time. Man!
You, I look forward to it. Yes.
Huh?
The axe be bloody ready!
Are we there yet?
Damn! Got stomped!
You are lucky, certainly.
Of course, this chromatic demon can keep changing to different elements. Mist, ice, fire.
Sitting here for centuries, doing nothing.
Hey! One of the masters told me to wait right here for further instructions, so I waited right here. I'm smart enough to know better than disobey an order from one of the masters.
Didn't you get bored or curious as to where everyone was?
Look! I'm an immortal spirit, okay? What's 1,000 years to me? And if you know how the masters punish disobedience, you wouldn't have moved for 1,000 years either. But the master's dead. I got no reason to stick around anymore, but since you did bring me the news that I'm free to go, I'll help you out. The whole place is powered by a magical fan. Without it, all the labs shut down. If you want to find anything else besides empty rooms, you should start that fan up again. There were 4 masters, and each kept a library in a lab. Air, slime, cold, and fire were the magics they practiced. The masters' pets and creations probably still inhabit their labs, so beware. Some of them are near unkillable if you don't know how to hurt them. A little hint for you. The masters were always planning to kill each other. Each master could use his own unique elemental power against one of the others. So, before you go stumbling into something you can't handle, you should check out all the libraries. The masters went into some pretty strange shit, but at least they kept written lab notes of their work. These notes will be invaluable.
Wait, I have more questions to ask you.
Sorry, I've wasted enough time hanging around this shithole. One last tip, though. Go to the air lab first. It's behind me. The fan has 2 settings, high and low. That might be important. And now I'm gone.
Little bastard.
Lots of places to search here. Cursing. The wand instantly renders the target blind, deaf, and mute. Perhaps the most dangerous aspect of this terrible device is that anyone can use it. Nice. More +3 arrows and +4 bullets. Wow.
Make up as I thought. Yeah, is this a joke?
That's the best. I can do that.
What do you? I am controlled by no one.
I'll have all this to sell, too. Full plate plus two. Symbol of Talos. Only the most worthy and devoted servants of the Stormlord are granted these powerful holy symbols. That's pretty nifty. ...5% magic resistance, 6th and the 7th level cleric spell, and plus 1 strength.
Making her stronger than me, huh? I need some strength enhancement. Lug-Lug's starting to be puny.
There you go, Dorn. Dorn can be invisible and sneak up behind, Lug-Lug and give him a pokey-pokey.
You know you want to, Dorn. You queer bait. Hurrah! Want me to do what, huh?
As you wish.
We'll take antidotes. We have what we need to upgrade our bag of plenty to plus 2 as well, so I'm just going to drop the plus 2 bullets for now. We'll go meet with Cespinar after Washer's Keep and get some upgrades done. And here, of course, is Elminster's Ecologies to teach us who and what to kill. This brief note is written in wild, looping, haphazard script. The words seem to be almost nonsensical babblings. No magic, long blue green, back, magic, back. LT to the M. And the fire library note. This note is scorched and blackened, obscuring much of the text. Companions are stubborn fools, demon almost immune to physical damage. Transforms it into ice incarnation. It is vulnerable to flame and fire, destroying the windbag air wizard and its pathetic servants. My giant is invincible!
Huh? Excuse me! Are we
right?
I can do it!
The giant fan room. Well, we'll get to tinker around with this in the next video. Thanks for watching.